Well, you guys are a great audience. I wish I had a better act. But I have discovered over the years that a lot of times people will miss some little step in a trick, even when it's being explained from this great a distance. Sometimes it's helpful to have a little personal instruction. What I'd like to do is find some spectator from the audience who'd like to learn the world's oldest magic trick. Do we have a volunteer?
Oh, me.
What? Okay, come on up. Come on up on the stage here. Hi, I pop. Your name is?
James.
Pleasure to meet you, James. You ever done a magic trick before?
Yes.
Oh. This may be easier than I thought. James, I'm going to teach you how to do one of the world's oldest magic tricks. You have to pay close attention, okay?
Not very good at that.
Oh, shut up. This is a classic, like Great Expectations. You have to learn it. Over 2,000 years old, the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking rings. James, this is ring number one. This is ring number two. This is ring number three. And this is ring number four. Four separate styles, bands of steel. You with me so far? Good, which one is this? Which one do you think it might be?
One!
Two.
Which one do you think it might be?
One!
One! Is that correct? Can you guess this ring, two?
Two.
See, this is going to be easier than you thought. What I want you to do, James, is pick a spot on your ring, any spot at all, that looks like a solid spot to you, so you can hold your ring like this, so the solid spot would be right up here. Okay? Both hands like that, really tight. Good. Does that look like a solid spot to you right there? You can feel it. Solid?
Yeah.
Did you notice any holes in your ring anywhere?
I hope not.
You missed one. That joke is over 2,000 years old. It used to be done in Chinese. But it's important to see, because without this hole, the trick won't work. Without this hole, it wouldn't even be the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking ring, would it? It'd be the ancient miracle of the Chinese linking hubcaps. See, the idea is to take this hole and put it into that hole, hold tight, which seems kind of odd when you think about it. In order for that to happen, solid steel has to pass through solid steel, the miracle of penetration. Ready? You ready?
Yep.
Don't blink. This may be the best shot some of you ever get at this ancient miracle. Solid steel. Solid steel. You ready? One! You hold them just like this, you give the rings a spin this way, kind of a circular motion, and then you blow right here in the center, like this. And they'll right through each other. Good, it's your turn. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on this stage, we're going to change around here. We'll keep the rest of this space in the legs of the main, over 2,000 years old. Let's hear it. This is ring number two. I want you to hold your rings up just like this. Okay? Like this. Perfect. This is ring number three. This is ring number four. I'm going to hold mine up the same way. On the count of three, I want you to drop one ring. On the count of three. Hold one ring tight, let the other ring just drop so they link together like that. On the count of three, watch your foot. Ready? One, two, three. Perfect. You have a natural talent for it. I can see it. That's what you did really good. Most people don't get this far in this trick. You are doing great. James, second part of the trick, taking the rings apart. Hold your rings like this. Give this ring a spin, like so. Okay? And then, see, that doesn't really do anything. That's just show business. Show business. When you give this ring a spin like this, and you throw one arm back, like this, and you step forward with the other one foot, and you stare straight in the face. Why? An intelligent crowd can't help it. They will break up and give spontaneous applause. See, that's show business. Show business is easy. Magic is tough. Hold your reins like this. Give them a spin this way, kind of a circular motion. Use a little less wrist action, more just that kind of stuff. Once you get it going, it's going to blow right here in the center. So you take your ring just like this. You blow right in the center. Ready? One, two, three, blow. And now right through each other. Now, for one ring up your arms, put the other ring down your chin. Take the ring on your shoulder, give it a push so it slides all the way down your arm, back inside this ring like so, and give it a spin like that. This far in this trick. Brings us to the second method for taking the rings apart. Hold your rings like this, give this ring a spin like so. Put that ring up, spin the other ring the same way. Then take your left hand, reach for the hole like this. Grab this ring down here, put it straight out to the hole like that. And then put it back through the hole the same way. So you end up with two rings, link back together again, like so. Perfect. All right, now. This brings us to the third, the final, the most difficult, and the most dangerous method ever devised for taking two solid metal rings apart. You ready for this?
Yeah.
Hold your rings like this, like a bow and arrow. What you're going to do is take the ring in your right, that's going to work for demo. What you're going to do is take the ring in your right hand, give it a spin so it goes sailing around this ring. It'll pass through right about here. Its momentum will carry it back towards your head, loose at a speed of about 20 miles an hour. In order to avoid serious bodily damage, you have to take your right hand, thrust it through the ring as it comes around. If you miss, you're going to get punked right on the noggin. You understand so far?
Yeah.
Let's go. Ready? Get set. One! Two! Three like that. It comes right off. Take that same ring. Throw it straight up in the air like this. And catch it in the air just like that. So you have two rings linked to you. If I take one of these rings, put it straight up like this, we end up with four rings interlocked so that every ring is linked twice to two other rings. Twice to two other rings. When we blow on these, they melt right through each other in a one long chain. When you collapse the chain, you end up with three rings on one ring. Which is impossible. Let's count these off. This is ring number?
One.
Four. Ring number four. This is ring number?
Three.
This is ring number two. And this is. And it's